Hello everybody, we're gonna do a Friday Eve video and I'm with the Eddie Horvath and what's going on here?
Putting a road in.
This is, we're up at Uncle Edmund's place, by the way, if you're wondering what's going on. Sorry about the wind, it's nothing I can do about it. But we're gonna do a little bit of walkthrough here and show you what we got accomplished. I was at work all day, so when I got home, Eddie already has the gravel on the roadway and, now, what kind of gravel is this, Ed?
This is what they call 57 commercial.
Okay.
It's made just for this.
And this is just the first part of putting a good road in. You want to get a good base down. We didn't put no fabric down.
But there was actually a road. There was a road in here before, and it's just as tight as you get a road.
So it's pretty well compacted underneath of here. Mm-hmm. And this gravel will be used up top here once we keep moving along here. So let's come around this side, and the last video I showed, we got to get a few more of these trees off to the side here because we're going to take this road and it's going to sort of come straight up through this bend. So right where these trees are standing here, they're in the way, so that's going to be our next bit of work up here. And we're going to clear it all the way back to that, where that big pile of dirt is. That's all that is piles and piles of dirt. Overburden, they call it. And you can even see pieces of coal left in that pile. And there's the old chipper up top the hill. You're going to put a little offshoot here, right? You're going to put a little...
Yeah, we're going to make a place just to put the machines and the trailer.
Little parking spot here. Mm-hmm.
Got to pull the stumps first.
Yeah, got to get this all out of here. We got the gravel to do it with. And then eventually all that mess will get cut down. And that's all usable dirt to go in that ravine someday. And you can just see pile after pile of dirt. And here's where Uncle Edmund's building is going to sit. Up the very top here. And this dirt... Eddie said it's mostly what, coal dust?
It's coal dust, yeah. A
little bit of topsoil.
We'll run into some topsoil.
And this will actually get cut out, some of this. So about right where you left off, we're gonna sort of flatten it across here. And it'll be about the same level as where the trailer's sitting at, roughly.
Roughly, yep.
And, but yeah, this is, we're into almost November now. And this is good. The leaves are down. We can get in here, do all the work we need to do. No mosquitoes.
It's dry.
Just lots of firewood. Lots and lots of firewood. Not much dirt to move.
No, not once you get to it. You go quicker than you think.
Yeah, so it won't be so bad up here.
Nope.
But yeah, we just want to give you a little update on what's going on here. And today's video is going to be sawing another 3 pine logs. And that's back when Rob and Dave were here and Mark was here. And that's what we're going to leave you with. So, hey, thanks for coming along. Enjoy the sawing part of the video. And we will catch you on the next one. So thanks again.
Thank you.
Alrighty. All right, let's get this Friday video going. Man, Eddie's getting things fired up out there. And it's good when you got a bunch of help here. It's been really a good day of sawing. We're still the same day as we sawed the last 2 videos. And I figured let's just get a Friday video shot while we're at it. So, back to the white pine. Alright, let me open the knees up. I don't want to sit square. We're going to find out if it'll go on the carriage without no problems here. There it goes. That one wanted to go too. We can't have that. All right. Let's bump it forward here. I got to go down further to turn it. Trying to get that bottom. There's a little piece sticking out there that I want to sort of get it off of there now. Kind of liking that. And we'll put the master dog down just to say we did. All right. Oh, let's start there. Again, we're just making a bunch of sheeting, or sheathing, or whatever you want to call it. One by. And we got some denim. Dave was just talking about that. I think we're going to send him home a piece or two. Wanted denim, I think you got some. Eddie was confused what I was saying. All right, where are we at? The path here, let's try to get this down to a 12-inch can without turning it. I mean, flattening it, not turning it. That didn't make sense. All right, let's see how it sits. A 1x8 right there. I think it's going to work out. I think this is the nicest log of the three we're going to saw. To flatten off a top or bottom just to get it centered up. Yep, we're not gonna make it. That's okay. We know how to do that. All right, let's just lay it down, trim that bottom. Make it as simple as possible. Oh, let me see. Am I going to bump that taper a little bit? Yeah, we'll take a little bit of it out. Start there. Let's just flatten it out. That's better. I'm gonna put that that faced its up back to the knees. We're going to leave the round part down. I'm going to back it up here a little bit so I can get the loader arms to help me here. Taper. Oh, Bill Ellis. Better? Yeah, that's something you gotta remember. Sometimes you don't. I'm looking at that thing. Alright. We're gonna screw that up a little bit. That's better. And the 1x12 is probably going to be just a little bit under, it's good. It's still over 11 and a half. All right, let's lay that down and start peeling off some 1x11 5/8. That was just going to splinter up and cause me all kinds of grief. I can saw this every day. This is kind of like cheating.
Now, if this was like 2x, we'd be cutting down to the exact number. Sheathing, we don't get that critical on it. No need to. And there it is. So if you need any 1x pine, look us up. I'm going to saw this down right into the pit, then turn it and leave it into the dog board. That should work about there. Just turn it to the knees, dig it down to a 2x8. We haven't sawed softwood for a while. All right. Continue down. Sharpen the blade after this. It's been a while. Still cutting nice. Ooh. Got some. In fact, I'm going to go out there and get that off of there right now because that's going to become a problem. That can cause you a world of trouble there. Bus motor, Louie. All right. Emergency over. Yeah, you gotta always be watching for something. That'll act like a set of brakes on that saw. Okay, I'm gonna get down to a full 2-inch. Like that. All right. Let's go get another one. Like we're sitting now, so I'll just shove her back here. And put the master dog down for safety. See it roll down? That's why you try to set it and run it forward. You don't want it doing that in the saw. We got a little piece of garbage that got in there. Eddie's trying to get her. I think you got her. I just want to get a little wider face here. On the last video, we had that little piece of knot come out and got right in that darn off bear belt. Cost us some nice
grave. I think I'm gonna roll this back now. And we'll try to get her down to 12. It just wants to go over more. We're gonna do that. Flatten the bottom out. That's way too much on the back side of that. Sometimes the way they're shaped, they just don't want to, they want to roll one way or the other. So I'm trying to get to a 12-inch tent, is what I'm trying to do. So we're going to take a little different route than end up the same. All right, let's go back to where we were. Looking better.
wanted to get rid of all that trash. It'll come in contact with that off air belt and cause me all kinds of grief. We're gonna get it down 8 inches. See where we're at in a bit. That'll work. Let's turn it right now. Wood comes out of a log. Oh, I'm gonna turn it out, then we'll take it down to 2. Get the pith just about into it. Take a thin one off. But it don't matter, it'll be used. I just want to end up with all 2x8s. you one more for this video. Nothing big, but we want to get her done. And this is not a nice log by any means here. This is what you call a porcupine. I like to bring a little naughty face up and get rid of it first. I'm probably going to get 1x10s out of this. Oh, let's start there. Turtle Island here. We got Big Dave out there, we got Rob, got a whole crew of people. I don't like these naughty faces. This is a Van Miller's worst nightmare this long. That thing would wave like a flag and boards. There's where the circle mill definitely. Is better than the man mill on naughty wood. I don't care. You can argue that all you want. Let's clean this face up a little bit here. See what we're dealing with. There we got an 8-foot board out of that. You always chop them down when you're cutting logs like this. You're not going to try to get a full 12-foot board out of the opening faces. So you will waste a lot of logs. One more board and we'll flip her down and start taking 1x10. Pick that piece up, or else I'll push the roller table. He's getting some sticks ready. Alright. That's why I get a kick out of some of these mills. They're shoving boards out so fast. If anything were to go wrong, it'd be bad. And that one got a red dot on it. Dave had a Sharpie and drew me a dot. This one here, I think I'm going to whittle down to a 6 inch. So I'm going to try to stay 3 inches each way. All right, let's roll back to the knees. Get this happy little painting done. And the taper's away, Bill. If anybody wonders about that, why we say, hey, Bill Ellis. Well, Bill's a good friend of ours. We met him at the Bunyan Show over the past 3 years. Just a great guy. We see him comment on all the videos. Just a little joke him and I have going. He said he'll be screaming at the computer watching it. Turn it or put the tapers back. This is not a nice log, but it is now bored. And we'll get one more, lay it down and get some sixes off. Talking to Pete, that's 319, and we're looking at buying a load of poplar, possibly. Very seldom we buy logs, but really can't rely on these street boys. So we'll get our own. It's a real nice one sitting back here just really going bad. They told them that they had that promise to somebody. It'll go bad before it gets long. All right, we're close enough to the pit there. Let's roll it back, make our 2x. I think we're going to give you the edge or cam on this video here. But you got pumpkin cam on the last one. Take a little man glitter off of this. Down our 2 inch. There it is. And that just about takes care of this log. All right, everybody, we will catch you here at the end.
So he got her home and parked her in the yard. That old bucket of bolt, to me she ain't no joke. She gets me there and home again every time. For 6 long months I had to work real hard, from buying all the parts and fixing her up as best I could. It's all started to blow, so I fixed it up with a coffee can and glitter wire. That old bucket of bolts, to me she ain't no joke. She gets me there and home again every time. Many long years have passed, and that truck, and it still lasts. It carried all the wood and stone to build my family a home. Somewhere along the way, the pickup box rusted away. A trip to the lumber yard, and a few feet of angle iron fixed her up right away. That old bucket of bolts, to me she ain't no joke. She gets me there and every time. When it's my time to go, you know just what to do. Put my pine box on the back of the truck. Take me for one last ride to the church where I wed my bride. Then plant me at the end of the road, next to all the folks I used to know. And talk about all the fun we used to have. That old bucket of bolts, to me she ain't no joke. She gets me there and home again every time. When it's my time to go, you know just what to do. Put my pine box on the back of the truck. Take me for one last ride to the church where I wed my bride. Then plant me at the end of the road, next to all the folks I used to know. And talk about all the fun we used to have. That old time. It's my time to go, you know just what to do. Put my pine box on the back of the truck. Take me for one last ride to the church where I wed my bride. Then plant me at the end of the road, next to all the folks I used to know. And talk about all
righty,
the
folks we used to have. And that is one impressive pile of lumber there.
It was.
And if it wasn't, hey, if it wasn't for all the guys that showed up here.
Oh my, I can't thank them enough.
Yeah, we shot 3 videos in one day, so if you're wondering why everything looks the same.
Yeah.
Well, it is the same.
Shirt's the same, time with the Yeti.
And he did not take a shower between Monday's video and this Friday Eve video.
No.
And I'm going to get a little bit further away from Eddie.
No, we're all good.
Yeah, we're all good there. And hey, thanks again. And also, if you're subscribed to the channel, please check your status. A lot of people have been saying that they're not getting no notifications. Hmm. And YouTube, for some reason, unsubscribes people.
I don't know why that is.
And I wish they'd quit doing that. And you know what else they're doing? They're making it very hard to do the closed caption. Every once in a while, I'll do a video, and it does not let you do it.
Yeah, we had a problem with that, too.
Yeah, you know, I don't understand that, why that they can't, you know, we got technologies today, you think they could do something better, but I do like reading them, though, because sometimes it'll be words that you're like, I didn't say that.
So,
again, if you liked it, please hit the like button, and if you're not subscribed, please subscribe, and if you are subscribed, check your status, and we will catch you on the next one, when we're sawing. I have no idea.
Yeah, go to Troy, Tree Guy.
Troy Tree Guy.
They're from Maine. Now, you've seen them helping us here.
Yep.
They came the whole way down here from Maine to help us. It was amazing.
All righty. We'll catch you on next one.
All right. Thank you.
Next bye-bye. To all the folks I used to know, and talk about all the fun we used to have. That old bucket of bolts, to me, she ain't no no joke.